Welcome dear students and friends in this 19th lecture on Python programming. And in the last class we had started a new topic which is file handling, and I had started with text files. I introduced you about files, and then I told you that we have to study about text files, binary files and CSV files. But we started with text files yesterday, and I gave you an introductory session yesterday in which I taught you that how to open a file and which are the different operations that can be performed on a file. So I told you that Python provides this facility that you can open a file, you can make some amendments into it through a program. So just like you are writing a normal program, you can write a program to manipulate the contents of a file also, okay? And that's what we started yesterday. So in the continuation of the same, today we will study in depth that which are the different functions available in Python for reading a file, okay? And then we will see some very important programs related to reading from a file, and then I will give you some assignments also, okay? So let's start. And I had told you about the open function yesterday, and so let's see what was open function. So in order to open a file, you need to write like this: f equal to open. You use open function, and open function takes two parameters. One is your path of the file. Okay, so let's suppose that this is the file available on my desktop, tile.txt, in which I am trying to read. Okay, so I will give its path. And then I told you about the path also, that how to specify the path, that you should write a raw string, okay? You should introduce write raw before it, otherwise it might give error, because it might treat this, suppose backslash, this is forward slash t, but if in your system the path is given like backslash, then definitely you should use this r, raw string, okay? Otherwise this will be treated as a special character tag. Okay, so in order to ensure that this is treated as a path, this is treated as a raw string, okay, and not something special string, not a special string, okay, you should ensure that you write r before the path. Okay, if you do not want to write r, then also I told you another alternative, that you should use double slices. Okay, so anyway, that we already discussed in the last class. So this is your first parameter, the path where your file is present, and then the mode. Okay, now I also told you that if you are going to read your file, then you need not to mention this r, this mode r need not be mentioned. Okay, by default the mode is read mode. Okay, anyway, so let's open the file. We have opened the file. Now what to do with the file? You have to read this file. Now which are the different functions that are available for reading? Okay, so that we are going to study today. So the first function that we will be studying is, this is readn, okay? Readn, okay? So what is readn? Readn means that you are going to read n bytes, okay? You are going to read n bytes from the from your file. I had told you that these all your characters are present in the form of ASCII values, okay? And one ASCII value equivalents 1 byte, okay? So if you are writing n byte, that means you are essentially going to read n characters from your file, okay? You are going to read n bytes, which is nothing but n characters from your file, underlying file, whichever file you have mentioned in your path, okay? So let's open this tile.txt file, and you can see that this contains I am in India, I am going, I am studying. So there are three lines, and you are trying to read from this file. Now which function you are going to use for reading? You are going to use readn function. So n means n bytes or n characters, okay? So let's use this function and see how it is used. So you can directly write printf.readn, or you can store the returned value in the form of a string. So it essentially returns the string containing n bytes, okay? So you may store it in some variable. So s equal to, just write f dot. So this is the way to call this function. You have to use this file handle. I told you yesterday that this file object should be used for the purpose of reading and writing, okay? So once you have opened a file, this file object gets created, and this file object essentially points to your file, okay? This is pointing to your tile.txt file, okay? And using this file object only, you will perform either read operation or write operation, or whichever operation you want to perform, okay? Now how to use this object? You use this as f dot read, okay? So I want to read, suppose, 5 characters, so I will write f dot read 5, okay? And now let's print s. Let's see what this s is giving, okay? So this s will be giving you I space M. So you know that space is also one character. Okay, space also has an ASCII equivalent. Okay, so five characters have been printed, and which are the five characters? I is one character, space is second character, then A is third character, M is fourth character, and your space is fifth character. Okay. Now, the essential thing to note is that once you have performed this read operation, your pointer is now at this I. Okay. Your pointer is now at this I. Okay. So, if you now perform, suppose you write F dot read 2, then which two characters will be printed? In. Okay, don't think that I space will be printed. Again, if you perform, so listen very carefully that after printing this, after giving this command f.read 5, if you again give f.read 2, then it will read from here. It will read from I onwards. Okay, and not from I space. Okay, it will not start from here, but instead it will start from here because your pointer is at this point of time. At this stage, okay. So let's try to see what I am trying to say. So now you have read your five characters. Now, so let's make it S1. I will write it as S1, and let's print this as S1. And another string will be, again, if you write F dot read. Suppose I am writing 2. So I space will not be printed, but in will be printed. Okay. So let's try to print S2 and see what output it is giving. You can see that this is giving in. Okay, so first it printed I space M. I am showing you all the three things. I am showing the program also. I am showing you the output also, and I am showing the text file also. Okay, so first it printed I space M space. Okay, five characters. Okay, two times space and then I M, and then when you again gave command F dot read 2, so it read from here, from I M. Okay, it read I M. So I hope you got the concept that once you perform the read operation, the pointer stays at that point of time. Okay, unless you close the file. If you close the file, it will again begin from the very beginning. Okay, it will again start at the beginning. But if you have not closed the file, then your pointer will be at this point. This stays. Okay. I mean, whichever characters you have read, that after that many character, your pointer will be present. Okay, so now you must have guessed that again, if I give suppose three characters, so it will print space IM. Okay, so let's try to do this. S3 is equal to f.read3, so it should print S3 equal to f.read3, and then you give this as S3. So you can see that it will be giving space IM. Okay, I hope it is clear to you. So first I printed five characters, then I printed two characters, that is in, and then again I printed three characters, so it gave space IN. Okay, so that's it about readN function. Now what is read function? Okay, so we completed our readN function for reading a file. So you can see that if you use readN function, then it reads n characters from your file. I will come to this absolute and relative path. First I will discuss these functions. So let's discuss the second function, read function. Now what happens if you are not providing read? Essentially means that you are not giving the value for n. Okay, it is a particular situation of this function. It is a particular case of this read n function. So if you do not specify any value for n, that is your read function. And what does this read function do? It reads all the content. Okay, it reads all content because you are not specifying that how many bytes you are going to, or how many characters you are going to read from the file. If you are keeping it empty, you are keeping n as empty. That means you are going to read entire content of your file and not some specific characters. Okay, you are not going to read some n characters from your file, 5 or 10 characters from your file, but instead you are going to read entire content of your file. Okay, so let's use this function and see what output it is giving. So let's print S1 now, and you can see that it will give the entire content of your file here. Okay, so let me close this one and rerun it. You can see that it is giving the entire content of your file. I am in India, I am going, I am studying. So all the three lines that were inside your tile.txt file, they have been printed on your screen. So I hope you got the concept. There is nothing to worry about these functions. Very trivial functions, you may say, but they are very useful also. Okay, they are very easy to use, but they are very helpful in reading your file. Okay, so this is essentially in the form of a string. So this S1 is nothing but your string. So if you want, you can print the type of S1 also, and you can see that it will be a string type of object. Okay, you can see that this is a string. Okay, so essentially whatever content is there in your file, that is getting printed in the form of a string. Okay, that is what it is actually doing, this read function is actually doing. Okay, we will see many different applications of this read function, okay, through when we will discuss the programs, but let me first discuss these file functions, the functions for reading from the file, and then I will tell you different advantages of it. Okay, when you will do the programs, then you will see that how advantageous these functions are. Okay, so let's see the next function, which is your read line function. Okay, so read line function, now by now you must have guessed that read line is doing nothing but it reads line from your file. Okay, it reads one line. Okay, it reads one line from your file, one line from your file. Okay, so let's try to use this function and see what output is it is giving. So instead of read, what I will do, I will use read line function. Okay, we have checked the type, it was a string, let's remove it and let's try to print the read line. Okay, so now I am using which function? Read line function, and I am telling it that it is giving, it prints, okay, it prints one line from your file. Okay, so it essentially not, it's essentially reading from the file and then printing also. Okay, so it prints one line from your file. So let's run this and see what output it is giving. It is giving I am in India. Okay, so this is the thing. Now again, what happens if you again call this function? Okay, what happens if you again call this function? So definitely it will give you the, it will print the next line, isn't it? It will print the next line. Okay, so let's try to, let's again call it s2 equal to f dot read line, and again print the line, the string returned by this read line function, and you can see that the second line is getting printed. You might be able to see that there is this extra line gap here. Okay, I hope you are able to see it, that between I am in India and I am going, there is a empty line, there is an empty line. Why it is so? Have you did you think about it? Okay, did you notice it? It is actually because that I had told you yesterday that at the end of your line, your new line is present. Okay, at the end of your line, at the end of every line, for example, after this I am in India, a new line character is present. Okay, so that new line is taking cursor to your next line. Okay, and you are using print statement also. Okay, you are using print statement also, and you know that after printing the line, the print statement introduces one more line. Okay, so after print statement is executed, whatever next comes, that is printed in a new line. Okay, so print statement also prints one line. Okay, so one new line is because of this backslash n, and another new line is because of your print statement. I hope you got the concept, that one new line is because already there is a backslash n present at the end of your line, isn't it? At the end of every line, this backslash n is present, isn't it? So one new line is getting printed because of this, and another is because of the print function itself. You know that print function introduces one new line. After printing anything, it introduces one new line. Now what if you want to stop this new line? What if you want only a single line? Okay, what if you do not want this blank line to get printed? You might be seeing that there are two line gaps actually. It is not, I am going should actually be printed in this particular space. Okay, but this new extra line is coming, and this extra line is coming because of what? It is coming because of the print statement. Okay, so how to remove it? You already know about the end statement. So just do end equal to null. Okay, you just make end equal to empty. So what it will do, that it will just print the line, and because of this backslash n, a new line will get created, and the next line will be printed in the next line itself, and not a blank space will not get created. Okay, so let's run this and you will understand what I am trying to say. Okay, so you can see that after, now this gap has been removed. Okay, now you can see that after I am in India, I am going is getting printed, and a blank line is not coming in between I am in India and I am going. Why? Because now you have made print end equal to empty. Okay, end equal to nothing.
Okay, so that means end is equal to empty. So that's why print is not able to introduce a new line. Okay, otherwise it was introducing a new line, and one new line was getting printed because of this backslash n, which is already present at the end of every line in your file. Okay, so I hope you got this concept. Okay, so next, here also you should print end equal to null. Otherwise, after printing the last line, again it will print the a blank line. Okay, so you can see that here I am in India, I am in going. Okay, so that's all about the read line function. Okay, and so it essentially prints one line from your file. Okay, and after reading the line, similar to the read n function, the cursor is at the next line. Okay, so you can see that after printing I am in India, the cursor is where? At this particular line. So as soon as you execute s2 is equal to f.readline, it is not printing the first line, it is printing this particular line. Why? Because the cursor is at the second line. And again, now cursor is where? Cursor is at this point. Okay, so if you again execute f.readline, it will print I am studying. Okay, so this is how it is actually happening. And you can print as many lines as you want using readline function. It is essentially going to print a single line from your file. Okay. So that's it about the readline function. Now let's see the next function, which is your readlines function. Very important, very useful, and many times we will be using this function. Okay. So let's see what is readline function. So readline function essentially returns all your content in the form of a list. Okay. Readlines function returns all the lines in the form of a list. Okay, so each line becomes an element of the list. Okay, so each line, so what does this readlines function do? That each line becomes an element of your list. Okay, so how it is actually happening, you will see in a moment. So again, so let me again keep it s1 or whatever variable. Since it is a list, it is going to return a list, so better to write it as l1. Okay, and now I am going to use which function? I am going to use read lines functions. Okay, so read lines function, what it will do, that it will return a list, and it will contain, the list will contain how many elements? It will contain 3 elements. Okay, how many elements it will contain? 3 elements. Why? Because there are 3 lines. Okay, so listen very carefully. What does this read lines function do? It reads your file. Okay, and the number of elements in the list become equal to the number of lines in your file. Since here there are 3 lines, so the list will contain 3 elements. So all these lines will become a string, and it will also become an element of the list. Okay, so what this list will contain essentially, it will, the first element will be I am in India, and then of course backslash n will be there. I have told you that there is a backslash n present at the end of each line. Okay, and what will be the next line? It will be I am going backslash n, and then I am studying. Okay, so there will be 3 elements in your list l1. So let's try to print this l1 and you will see what output it is given. Okay, so you can see that this is giving 3 elements. This list is containing 3 elements. You can see that L1 is nothing but a list. It is containing 3 elements. First element is I am in India / n. Second element is I am going / n. And the third element is I am studying. Okay. Since there was no new line, there was no, this was the last line. So there is no / n present at the end of this line. Okay. Otherwise, there will be / n at the end of every line. This is what I was saying you throughout the previous session also, and throughout this session also, that this is your end of line, this is your delimiter. Okay, present at the end of every line. Okay, and if you use read lines function, you can view it also. Okay, so this is, as I told you, that very, very important function, read lines function. How it is going to be important for you, you will understand it. Let's try to see some advantages of this read lines function. For example, if I ask you to write a program to print number of lines present in your file. Okay, so this was one of the programs I mentioned it here also, that write a program to count number of lines in your file. Okay, write a program to count number of lines in a file. So how will you count it? Now you must have understand that if you use read lines function, all your lines will be returned in the form of a list. Okay, so if you print length of this list, won't it give the number of lines present in your file? Of course it will. Okay, so if you print length of this L1, so length of L1 will be equal to number of lines present in your file, isn't it? I hope you agree with me. So you can see also that this L1 was containing how many elements? It was containing three elements. Okay, the first element was I am in India, second element was I am going, and the third element was I am studying. Okay, so just forget about this backslash n, need not to worry about it, but it was containing three elements. And how many lines were there in your file? There were three lines. Okay, so if you print length of L1, it will give you how many lines are there in your files. Okay, so let's try to print this len of L1, and you will see that it will give you the number of lines present in your file. Okay, if you want, you can print this message also, that number of lines in file is, okay, and then you can print len of L1. So you can see that number of lines in file is 3. Okay, and there were 3 lines also. Okay, so the number of lines is nothing but number of elements in your list, which is returned using read lines function. Okay, so okay, now the another program was that write a program to print first and last line of a file. Okay, write a program to print first and last line of a file. Okay, so how will you do? Again, very important, very easy also. Okay, now you know that all the elements will be in the in this list, all your lines will be in this list. So you want to print the first line. So how will you print? You know that L0 will be nothing but, sorry, L10 will be nothing. Let's write L itself. There is no need to write L1. So you know that L0 will be nothing but your first line, isn't it? The first element of the list will be your first line of the file, isn't it? And the L-1 will be what? It will be the last line of your file. Okay, so you just print this message that first line, okay, first line of file is, and then you print L0, isn't it? You just write L0, and you can see that it is giving you I am in India. Again, you can see that here blank line is coming. Why? Because it printed this first line, there was a backslash n, it introduced a new line, and there was a new line introduced by print also. That's why this extra line is coming. Okay, so if you want, you again you can minimize it, okay, by using the and. Okay, so you just write and equal to and empty. If you do not want to, if you want to print that extra line, it is okay. Okay, no problem. But if you do not want extra line, then you should write and equal to empty. Now what should be the last line? Okay, so the last line of the file will be nothing but L-1. Last line of the file is nothing but L-1. Okay, so you can see that it is giving you correct output. First line was I am in India, and the last line was I am studying. Okay, so this is the correct output, and it became possible only because of this read lines functions. Okay, now can you print line by line? Can you print all the lines of your file line? For example, suppose I want to write the message that first line is this, second line is this. Okay, so can you print like this? Definitely. Again, you can iterate over this loop. So this is your loop, and this is your list L containing all your lines. So you can iterate on this list. So you just write for line in L, okay, and you want to print every line of your file line by line. Okay, so you just print this message that okay, so print, you just print line. Okay, so what it will give? It will give you the first, it will print the first line, then it will print the second line, it will print the third line, like that. Okay, so let's see this, what it is giving. Again, this is, there is a extra line. Okay, so again you can use this and equal to empty. Okay, so now you can see that it is giving you. So either you can use, so there are two ways to print all the contents of your file. One is your this read lines function, and you can use this read function also. You had seen that using read function, your content, your entire content of the file is returned in the form of a string. So you have two options. Either you can use read, you can have many ways to print, not only two options. One For example, one way that we saw today was this read function. You can use read function, you can print the entire content, or you can use read lines function and then you can print it line by line in this fashion, okay, in this manner. Okay, so the next topic was that you have to print the, now this one I am giving you as an assignment, whether I will see whether you can do it or not. You have to write a program to count number of characters in a file, and just add one more program to count number of words in your file. Okay, not only characters, your first program you have to write for counting characters and another program for counting words in a file. If you want, you can print both these in a single program, it's up to you. If you want, you can write separate programs. Okay, so you have to write programs to count number of characters in a file, and you have to also write program to count number of words in a file. This I have already demonstrated to you how to count number of lines in a file. I did the easy one, okay, but don't worry, these two are also very easy. Okay, I am just trying to see whether you can do it or not. Otherwise, I will definitely discuss it in the next class. We will see many programs, as I told you that this is going to be a very long session. Okay, maybe more than five to six lectures I will record on this file, because there are many important programs to discuss. And after completing all these theoretical things, after telling you about all these functions, I will move on to programs, and we will see many programs based on file. We will understand their logic, how it actually works. Okay, then these functions will become more clear to you. So we discussed about all these functions, read line. Read is nothing but a special case of this read n function, where you do not provide value for n, and read is does nothing but it prints all the content of your file. And read line reads single line, and read lines returns all the content of your file in the form of a list. Now you can use the list in whatever way you want. You can print the first line, you can print the last line, you can print any line. Suppose someone asks you to print the second and third line, so you will print L1 and L2. Okay, L0 will be your first line, L1 will be your second line, L2 will be your third line, and so on. So you can print specific lines also. That's a very advantage of this read lines functions. You can print the number of lines present in your file using this read line function. Also, you can, if you want, you can print the first and last line, etc. Okay, so now let's see one more program based on this read lines function, and now you will realize that what is its advantage. For example, I ask you to write a program to print, to print the lines, okay, is starting with I. Okay, suppose I want to print all those lines which start with I. Okay, I want to read the lines from the file, but I only want to print those lines which are starting with I. For example, in this situation, all these three lines are starting with I, so all these three lines should be printed. Let me add some more lines. Okay, so let me add some more lines into it. India is my country. Okay, India is my country. Okay, India is an Asian country. Okay, so I am adding, so there are five lines, but okay, sorry, this is also starting with I. So let me add something different. Khairagarh is in Chhattisgarh, then Raipur is capital of Chhattisgarh. Okay, so let me add these two lines, and you can see that these two are not starting with I. Okay, so there are five lines, but only these three should be printed. Only those lines which are starting with I should be printed. So how you will write a program? Again, we will use this read lines function. Okay, so let me write a fresh program. Everything has become hodgepodge. So let's open this file again. F equal to open. Okay, so I will copy paste this one. Let me just copy paste this one, and this time I will remove this R, just to show you that even if you do not mention it, automatically it will be opened in the read mode. Okay, so I am not specifying any mode in this particular example. Okay, so now let's read the file. Okay, so L equal to F dot read lines, and you know that all your lines will be returned in the form of a list. Now you will check every line in your list. Okay, for every line in L, you will iterate over your list. Okay, you will check every line present in the list. Okay, and you know that this line will be nothing but a string. Okay, line will be nothing but what? This line will be, okay, line will be a string. Okay, and you know that if you want to check the first character of your string, how do you check it? You just check f line 0. Okay, so line 0 will be nothing but the first character of your line, and if this line 0 is equal to I, so essentially this line is nothing but a string, and you are checking first character of this particular string, and if it is equal to I, then you have to skip. Okay, you have to just continue. Okay, if you have to continue, else what you have to do, you have to print your line. Okay, you have to print your line, that's it. Okay, so if line 0 is equal to I, you need not do anything. Okay, otherwise you have to print your line. Okay, so I hope you understood the logic, that this, you read your line, you, this line is nothing, this L list is your lines contained in the file. Okay, you are checking every line in the list, and you are checking first character of it, that if the first character is I, then in that case you are continuing, you are doing nothing, otherwise you are printing that particular line if it is not starting with I. Okay, or if you want, you can, okay, so let me run this. Okay, so let me first run this, and you can see that it is only printing these two lines. Okay, Khairagarh is in Chhattisgarh and Raipur is capital of Chhattisgarh. Why? Because these two lines were not starting with I. Okay, again you have to print and equal to empty, otherwise it will print two lines. Okay, so that's why you have to write and equal to blank. Okay, if you want, you can further minimize it. You can write here only that if line 0 not equal to I, okay, then in that case only you have to print your line, otherwise you just write nothing. Okay, you need not write the else part also. So you can see that it is giving you correct output. So both way you can do. Okay, so that's it. And okay, so before ending this lecture, let's discuss about this absolute path and relative path. Okay, so this path that you are mentioning here, this is your absolute path. You are giving the complete path. Okay, this is your complete path, isn't it? If you want, you should not write this. This is very kind of lengthy thing. So if your file is present in your, okay, so if your file is present in the same folder where your Python is installed, then you can mention relative path also. Okay, so if you are giving this complete path, this is an example of absolute path. Okay, so this is an example of absolute path, the path that you have specified. Now what is relative path? Relative path means that where your file is present relative to your Python folder. Okay, where your file is present relative to your Python folder. Okay, so for example, if your file is present in this Python folder only, where you have installed your Python, then you just give the file name. For example, there is a file test.txt. okay, so let's give this file test.txt. okay, so in that case you need not mention this absolute path. Okay, you just give the file name and it will be able to access it. Okay, so this is your relative path. Okay, this is nothing but relative path. Okay, you are just specifying the file name. That means where the file is actually present. Okay, the file is present in the Python folder itself. Okay, where you have installed your Python. Okay, so in that case you need not give the absolute path. Instead you can give the relative path. You can just give the file name and it will be able to open and read from it. Okay, so you just run this and see what output it is giving. Okay, so you can see that it is reading the content of the file. It was not starting with I, so it printed everything. Okay, so now I hope you understood that this is relative path. If you want, in this case also you can give the absolute path, you can give the complete path if you wanted. And how to give the complete path? You just copy it, as I told you yesterday. You just press Ctrl C and then you come here and do Ctrl V, and you can see that it is not your relative path now, it is your absolute path. Okay, it is absolute, we are giving complete path. Okay, so you can see that it is giving you the correct output. So it is up to you if you want to give absolute path or relative path. Better to give absolute path, I will suggest. Okay, if there is not an issue, if the path is not so long. Okay, Otherwise, if you are mentioning relative path, then you have to think where your file is present relative to this Python folder. Okay, so it will be a bit difficult to think for you guys. Okay, so for time being, you just use this absolute path. You can mention absolute path, and you just mention our raw string before it. Okay, if in the path it is using backslash. Okay, especially. Okay, and you should only use relative path. If you are mentioning relative path, make sure that it is present in the, so for example, if you are writing only file name, then it should be present in the same folder where your file is present, okay, where your Python is installed. Okay, so this is now your relative path, and whenever you are mentioning relative path, you make sure that this particular, you are just mentioning the file name, you make sure that this particular file is present in your Python folder. Okay, so that's it for today. And in the next class, we will see some more programs. And before that, we will study about the write function, okay, that what write function does. And we will study about the different types of write functions, okay, and I will demonstrate to you that how write function actually works. And till then, you try to submit these two assignments, to count the number of characters in a file and to count the number of words in a file. Better to write a single program for these two, okay. If you want, you can print the count the number of lines also. Okay, so you write a single program which counts lines also, characters also, and words also. Okay, so that's it for today. Let's meet in the next class. Thank you.